Hey, you people of family. So, last night I made this video, and for some reason I just, after we watched the rest of The Shining, I just could not stay awake. So, here it is. Hey, you people of family. So, yesterday we finished The Shining book. And today we started the 97 version that was on TV. And so we're getting the whole idea. Of course, everybody's seen the Stanley Kubrick classic in 80. And so of course, the book is a beast. It's 660 pages on the Kindle, and there's a lot going on. And Joey even said it herself. She said that Stephen King could be long-winded for a simple idea. And I tend to agree. Not that I don't love his detail, because I'm a detailed guy with my writing. But yeah, he can get carried away. So I think we're gonna finish the rest of the 97 version tonight. And but to me, I'm kind of starting to lean towards putting it up there above Kubrick. I guess because it adheres to the source material more. Now, I think Joey and I both agree that the kid that plays Danny in the TV show, he just didn't do it. They changed his age from being 5, 6 years old to being 9, and that kind of changes the trajectory. Joey just said, from 6 to 9 didn't seem like a lot, but when you're talking about a kid, that's a hell of a difference. I mean, they've lived a lot in those 3 years. The world, it might be, it's still pretty new, but they've seen a lot, and they're in school, so they're seeing even more, as opposed to being in maybe kindergarten or maybe a head start kind of thing. Don't know, he just seems a little too knowledgeable. And of course, I understand he's supposed to shine. And so he's supposed to know a little bit more, but the 80 version was, he just had that total innocence about him. And of course, Shelley Duvall, of course, she did a really nice job with playing Whitney, but when you read the book, she didn't look anything like their description, and Rebecca De Mornay did. And Jack Nicholson, I mean, what can you say? Jack Nicholson, I mean, he's gonna shine whatever he's doing. And so you can't crap on his betrayal. But I don't know. It's just seeing this new version and reading the book, kind of, I can understand why Stephen King was and still to some extent is pissed off what got done with his Shining in theaters. I don't know, because my book hasn't made it to the big screen, so I don't know how I would do with somebody's take on my material. Now, Joey's got hers getting looked at by Lionsgate, as you guys that have been with us know. So, we're hoping that'll turn into something good and big and be what we think it should be. But anyways, yeah, so we finished Shining, we're gonna finish the movie, and then Joey chose to read Christine next, which we've watched thousands of times, easily. We watch it every time it comes on any channel. So she'll get to see the difference in that one. Of course, I've read The Shining and Christine and It and Thinner and The Talisman. All those when I was in high school and when I first started college. So it'll be a good refresher for me. But anyways, guys, so those are the thoughts on our Shining experience. So yeah. So guys, have a good night. We love you. Be good to each other. And catch you later.